the Rock Metal Podcast, episode 230 with ELM TREE CIRCLE.
I've been dying to see you, waited for quite some time, only let this grow 7 years.
Rock Metal Nation, what is up? This is John from the Rock Metal Podcast. That sample you just heard was Yes It Is by ELM TREE CIRCLE, who I've got on the show with me right now. They've got a new album called The Good Life that's released via Crowd Records. Right now I'm being joined by what appears to be the entire band or some members of the band to share some stories about the music and share more info about what they've got going on. So guys, welcome to the show.
Hey John, thanks for having us.
Absolutely, great to have you on. Let's go and listen back to that track, Yes It Is.
I
got back from Yes It Is, definitely a killer track. I just all around, from what I've heard of the album, I just love the melodies that you guys have, and there's definitely no shortage of melodies in Yes It Is. I'm curious, what's the story or inspiration behind the track?
So Yes It Is pretty much a post-breakup track. So the entire album kind of deals with my personal breakup from a couple years ago. And Yes It Is the last track on the album that kind of sums up the whole theme of the album. And it's about how I kind of went through all this pain and then in the end came to the realization that it's actually not too bad and everything falls into place after a while. Mm-hmm. And so it's kind of like the happy upbeat song at the end of the album after going through a bunch of stuff with the other songs.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. All right, now for Rock Metal Nation, who dug the track Yes It Is, will be excited to know that there is a music video they can check out. So if you go and go to today's show notes, that's www.therockmetalpodcast.ca. You can check it out. Now, if you wouldn't mind, if you're taking us behind the production of the music video for Yes It Is.
Yeah, we went on tour with our friends from England called Death by Shotgun. And we played in a bunch of shows in England. Then we went back to Germany and toured a lot. And while we were on tour with them and a couple other bands, we always had our camera with us. So we just kind of filmed whatever came to our mind, whatever happened. And then we thought, wait, why don't we take all this footage that we have, take all the good bits out of it and put it in a music video and kind of show, like, this is us. Like, this is us on tour. This is what we do. Without any like makeup on, you know, like just, this is just us raw and, not trying to hide anything, not trying, just showing, yeah, we do play still a lot of small venues, not a lot of people there sometimes. We're not going to hide that. We're going to show all of it. We're going to show how we sleep on floors and couches, on some people's, apartments or some people that we just met that night. And, we thought we'll take all this footage and then we gave it like a VHS look to it because we're 90s kids and we grew up with a lot of like 90s cartoon and we still value all this like alt nostalgic feeling that we have from back in the day. And we wanted to make it look like a VHS video, like a home video that we would have with our friends or parents from back in the day.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I definitely got that vibe. So it definitely came through. So congratulations on that.
Thank you. Thank you.
Absolutely. All right. Let's go to listen to the next track, Feel the Burn.
They just put you at the center of their life because you're powerful. And then because they put you there, they want you to be less powerful. Never going to happen, though, right?
Never.
Help me on a road. Get me into something. Tap me in the flow. Drag me up to upswing. Flat me into love. Old days, make me use the tub, wash out all the cold waves now. Do you feel the burn sneaking up behind you? Hate me in return, a way to make it up to. If you see me crawl like that icy subway, just stay in the car. I could use a rough day now. Shake me like a bum who needs to see his talents. Beat me like a drum and turn us into gallons. If it's not enough, treat me with your absence. If you read me bluff, sentence me with suspense now. Do you feel a burn sneaking up behind you? Hate me and return, a way to make it up to. If you see me crawl, subway, just stay in the car. I could use a rough day now. Feel the burn sneaking up behind you. Hate me in return, a way to make it up to. If you see me crawl back the rusty subway, just stay in the car. I could use a rough day now.
Metal Nation, it's John from the Rock Metal Podcast for a real quick break to let you know that Jay over at Metal Mayhem Radio is looking to help you get your band in rotation on his station. So go ahead and hit up Jay at studio@metalmayhemradio.co.uk. That is studio@metalmayhemradio.co.uk. Just go ahead and say that the Rock Metal Podcast sent you. He'll get you into rotation on Metal Mayhem Radio. I come back from Feel the Burn. Now, I remember you were saying that pretty much the entire album deals with breakups. So my next question would be, well, what part of the breakup is Feel the Burn?
Feel the Burn is the first track on the album. and kind of brings you into the entire theme. So it's at a stage where, so you got to think of the album, it's kind of like chronology of a breakup. So it starts out with a relationship that's turning a little bad, and you're really stuck in a low. And Feel the Burn was a song about, yeah, being in a low, needing a good friend, and needing some help, because you already feel something is coming up, like a feeling of doom is creeping up on you from behind. That's the do you feel the burn sneaking up behind you? And around the time when I wrote this song, the lyrics to it, there was this entire, you probably noticed this in Canada a lot too. There was back in the day when Hillary was up against Donald Trump, and then there was still Bernie Sanders in the game. And back then, I had a good friend from the States living with me, and we were both kind of hoping that Bernie Sanders would have a chance. So for me, this was sort of like a secret call for like for help, like, oh, where's this entire situation going? Like my personal life, the entire world steering, kind of life going crazy. So it was like kind of a call for help for a friend. And I saw like, I saw a friend, like someone I didn't know, but I saw someone in Bernie Sanders that I kind of trusted, me personally, and my friend from the States, Sue. So I first had the intention to call the song Feel the Burn as in like Bernie, but then as time passed and it just was a little late for that after after we had to switch record deals and stuff. But still, I still tell the story because some people bring it up because they heard about it or something. So that's kind of like a little ambiguous thing in the song.
Cool. Now, for Rock Meditation, who dug the track Feel the Burn, will be excited to know that there is a what appears to be a food-based lyric video that they can check out. So if you go and go to today's show notes at www.therockmetalpodcast.ca, you can see what to do with your mayonnaise and ketchup next time you're in a restaurant. So wouldn't mind taking us through, Nick, what the production of the lyric video.
So we had the idea. Have you ever seen the movie Napoleon Dynamite?
Yes, yes.
Yeah, yeah. So you might remember, but or maybe not, but if you watch it again, pay close attention to the opening credits, because we pretty much took the entire opening credits from that movie. The movie starts out with a lot of food being served into the camera, and every like the producer and the name of the cast, they're all written in on the plates with like ketchup and stuff. And the only thing that like the food changes, and if you've watched the whole movie, and I think I don't know who told me this, but like some friend of mine is really into this movie, and he told me if you pay close attention, like all the food that you see in the intro is the actual food that they serve in the movie, and all the carpets and floors that you see, it's all from the settings of the movie. So I thought it was a really cool idea, and we watched the movie and we're like, what if we make a lyric video just like that? So Yo and Hannah, actually, I don't know how long did it take you?
One day, I think.
Yeah. So Joe's parents, they run a cake place, like how do you say, like a bakery, pretty much. Mm-hmm. And I was like, well, that makes kind of sense. Like, why don't you guys do the video at Joe's place? Because back then I was still in Berlin, and they were living 5 hours away here in Dortmund, where we're right now, and in West Germany. And so they sat down in like entire afternoon and cooked all the food, and they made an actual cake with some lyrics on them, and then just shot it down. And then at the end, we put a little picture of Napoleon Dynamite into the camera too, and say, I think it's saying like a tribute to. Yeah. Mm-hmm. And we had a little thing going on with Fortune Cookies on the first record, on the EP. There's one song about a fortune cookie, and so we thought, hey, why don't we just also throw a fortune cookie in there? And so there's this one fortune cookie that says a tribute to, and then there's a picture of Napoleon Dynamite, and that's pretty much the Yeah, it's a story about that video.
Cool. All right, now for Rock Metal Nation, who dug the two tracks, Yes It Is and Feel the Burn, we're super excited to know that Via Crowd Records is a full album called The Good Life. Now, Nick, I know you mentioned that pretty much the entire album is like a post-breakup album or deals with a breakup, but I'm curious if you wouldn't mind, when we pick up the album The Good Life, what should we expect?
You'll get a good mix of upbeat and sometimes sad songs. But overall, it's a good mixture. Like we didn't go for a particular one sound. There's a little bit of like punk rock in there, a little bit of pop punk, and then there's even a little bit of kind of like lo-fi beachy tunes in there. And for me personally, it was a self therapy. And if you're going through stuff similar to this, or if you just want to listen to some catchy tunes, I think this might be a record for you.
Now, the next logical question on Rock Metal Nation's mind is, how can we find out more about you guys? Is there a website that we should go to?
Exactly. We have elmtreecircle.com.
Cool. Boom. Well, boys, was there anything else you wanted to throw out there? I just wanted to thank you for taking time out of your day to come onto the Rock Metal Podcast and sharing Elm Tree Circle with Rock Metal Nation.
Thank you so much, John, for taking the time, and thanks for interviewing us. We had a blast. Thanks so much. It was great.
Help me out a road. Get me into something. Tap me in the flow. Drag me up to upswing. Flap me into love. Pull me out of old days. Make me use the tub. Wash out all the cold waves now.
All right, Rock Metal Nation, hope you just found your new favorite band in Elm Tree Circle. Big thanks again to them for coming on and sharing their music with us. Make sure to head over to www.therockmetalpodcast.ca to get all the information on the show you just heard today. And until then, rock on, Rock Metal Nation!